Hey, what's up guys? Deathtrek here. Back with another video. This time I'm going to be going over League of Legends and setting up how I set up my config for my Steam controller. For most of my top downs, I've been now using pretty much generally the same thing, which is the mouse region is going to be my primary mouse movement.
30 seconds until minions spawn.
And when you have mouse region gyro, actually, when you have that set up as your primary mouse movement, you can't use any other mouse inputs. That means that your pads are going to be useless when you're using gyro mouse on your gyro mouse region, which frees them up to be used as buttons, which I do. So my left pad is going to be my movement down. It's a directional. I'll show you what it looks like. It's basically a directional pad. And the other one, my left, is a directional pad also set up as buttons. So so if we go into the Steam overlay here, I'm in combat, so you have mouse and combat, so you're gonna have to hit the back button to switch over to combat mode, which is how you play the game. QW is left and right. If you hold the Q, it's gonna level it up. If you tap it, does the ability. Same thing with this one. E and R over here, hold E and R to level them up. Up and down is gonna be your loadout abilities, up is going to be D and up is going to be F, and down is going to be right movement on the right pad, and this is attack move. So it basically, I have it set up to where it'll attack the closest target to wherever I click on the attack move. The bumpers are going to be 1 and 2, and then the buttons are 3, 4, 5, and 6. I don't know, I guess there's 7 and 8. I don't see where you would do that. You can move things around in your bag to make them work. I don't know why. It's a lot of buttons. It just seems a little excessive if you're using all 8 buttons there, plus your normal attacks. B to port back to base to buy things, hold for left alt, and lock camera, which I don't really use that much. Hold escape for hold to use escape, and tap for tab. So you can look at the score menu, left mouse, and then the alt combat basically is alternative buttons for combat. It's kind of like a mode shift. I do this basically to kind of get a broader view of what I'm doing, so I don't have to go into sub menus, and it works fine for right now. So G, left mouse, that's so I can quick ping on the ground for and then V for retreat. Also, if you hold these, and then you can use the mouse region to kind of pick the other submenu chats, and I'll show those off here in a second. So that's kind of what I have right now. I mean, if you're new to the Steam controller, I mean, that's a lot of information that just went through. If you're not, I mean, you kind of understand where this setup went to. So again, mouse region here. Leveling up, I can either click it like this, or like I said, if I hold while I'm moving, let's say I want to level Q, I can just hold that. And you can see I'm still, my mouse is over here, and I just leveled Q up, right? So I held left there. Attack move, see how it's a red? That's your attack move. It's going to attack once it gets within range of that target. And attack. So that's pretty much it. If you played League or any other MOBA, this is standard MOBA. This game feels a lot slower at the beginning, then it just kind of picks up pace at the end compared to Heroes of the Storm, which seems like it's an all-out battle almost right from the start. Characters move faster, I mean, pretty much at full speed in Heroes, while in this game, you start gaining speed, and it feels like everything kind of picks up here. See, I mean, if you want to be accurate this game, you can. It's not hard. This is all with the gyro. I'm not using any mouse pad. I need to level up my E, so I'm just going to hold that. I'll level up again. I mean, I'm not, it's everything's set up so you don't have to go around and click stuff, you know? I'm just giving you guys a little gameplay so you can see how this works out. Sorry, I'm a little focused here. You know, this game is so competitive against robots, against bots, robots, whatever. Another thing too is like getting used to this. Armed and ready. Getting used to the different plays that you do compared to heroes took some time. All the options in this game are crazy though. Heroes, you level up, and then you have four abilities to choose from. Those just augment your build. And this one has so many different items. And I've looked at a couple, but man, to learn everything, it's almost better to stick with one, maybe two characters, than to stick with and try to learn them all. In Heroes, it's a little bit easier to get it down. Play multiple classes. So. Anyways, guys, that's basically the way I use this control scheme. Like I said, the top buttons are going to be your bumpers are going to be 1 and 2, and then everything else, so you don't have to do much. The camera seems to work pretty well. If this is the camera, if you need to use it to kind of look around real quick. I was going to show you, so if I hold this down, I can click on the ground. And if I hold them, that's when it brings up the radio menu that you can use. So. You need to do that. So everything's built into this scheme. I'm sure I'm missing some stuff. Like I said, I'm new. Not sure where.
Reporting in.
I'm not sure if there's some other things that unique things that you can do. In this game, I know there's wards and stuff you can set out. A ward totem. check that out. But I should just be able to hit four wherever I want. I don't know why it's not. Look at my door now. This is broken. Guys, I'm gonna try to finish this out and enjoy. I'll put this up in the description later.